In the 1st century AD, an extremely talented Roman glassmaker created a new and revolutionary form of glass called Vitrum Flexile. Unlike normal glass, it was reported that Vitrum Flexile was unbreakable. Written accounts describe the unknown glassmaker presenting his discovery to Emperor Tiberius for inspection. To test the glass, Emperor Tiberius threw the glass to the floor, but it wouldn't shatter. Emperor Tiberius was concerned that this unbreakable glass would greatly undermine the value of silver and gold, and the glassmaker was executed. With his death, the method to create Vitrum Flexile was lost to history. Attempts have been made, but so far, no modern method has been able to produce a glass that is unbreakable like Vitrum Flexile. It's likely that we may never again be able to produce a truly shatterproof glass. Silphium was an herbal wonder drug that the Romans used as an early form of birth control. This blend of herbs was created from a plant that could only be found growing along the coast of modern-day Libya. Silphium's powers as a very effective contraceptive made it one of the most valuable substances in the Roman world. Roman accounts of this early form of birth control describe it as, quote-unquote, worth its weight in silver coins, and that it was a gift from the god Apollo. All that was required in order to prevent a pregnancy with silphium was to ingest silphium juice every few weeks. Unfortunately, silphium's scarcity, combined with an overwhelming demand for its properties, more than likely led to over-harvesting, which drove the silphium plant into extinction. Thankfully, however, modern forms of birth control are up to the task, but it is likely that silphium is forever lost to history. At one point, while experimenting with mechanical oscillators, Nikola Tesla allegedly generated such a strong resonance inside several buildings that his neighbors lodged complaints with the police. After one experiment, Tesla caused such intense shaking that he was forced to use a sledgehammer to terminate his experiment. Like many other of Tesla's inventions, Tesla never finished his investigation into creating artificial earthquakes, and the designs for his machine were lost shortly after his death. In 1956, an aviation trade publication reported that Thomas Townsend Brown had made substantial progress in anti-gravity research. In fact, Thomas Brown made so much progress that his research was classified just a year later in 1957. Brown's work remains controversial because Brown himself believed that his discoveries explain the existence and operation of UFOs. Today, no one has replicated Brown's anti-gravity devices, and the original designs remain classified and apparently unused to this day. Not all lost technology is necessarily ancient. The designs for the Saturn V rocket, which brought humans to the moon, have essentially been lost to history. The trouble is that very few schematics of the Saturn V are still around. Some parts of the Saturn V were also designed and built by private contract, and once the moon program ended, these engineers did not preserve their designs. Many components of the Saturn V are also built with obsolete technology that simply does not exist anymore. On top of this, the death of many of the Saturn V's original engineers has made the construction of another Saturn V a very unlikely event. In fact, due to the sheer amount of lost knowledge, it's likely that it's now impossible to build another Saturn V rocket. For more top lists like this, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. And if you want to keep up with our latest videos, hit that bell icon on mobile. Or if you're on desktop, hit the gear icon and check Send Me All Notifications. It really helps us out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next time.